big service ahead of us, ladies and gentlemen. But before we get any further, I'm going to introduce to you Tony Gillis, who is a former Coventry rider from there at rugby and current member of the Speedway Patrol. Tony, good morning to you.
Of course, really helped me a lot. Well, Nigel did such a lot for me, especially when we went to Australia in the early days, because I was just a young kid, like the new kid on the block when I went over there. And Nigel sort of helped me such a lot, because, you know, when you went over there like for 4 months at like 18 years old, you know, you got all kinds of problems and stuff like that. And, you know, homesickness and, you know, working on your bikes and how to be independent was something that Nigel taught me. And, you know, he did teach me a lot of stuff. He was a great help to me, Nigel.
Oh, I know that. So what a great turnout.
Well, it really is awe-inspiring, isn't it? To see so many people. We're turning back the clock now to the 1960s, early 70s. You know, Nigel gave his utmost. He gave everything for this, for the random bees, and it's really great to be here.
All the pictures going round, we want you to stand up, put your hands together, and really give Billy a wonderful final lap send-off here at Brandon Stadium. So we'll make sure Tom's okay. Ladies and gentlemen, Little Tom, Peter Collins, and the Ashes of Nigel Boocock, come on, raise the roof! John Harry has got the honour of waving the flag for Billy. Keep those applause going, Little Boy Blue, coming home to his beloved Coventry brand new track. Peter Collins, ex-world champion, doing the honours for Billy. Great friend and colleague. John Harry with the flag. Brilliant.
But anyway, we did, and we had some ding-dongs. Good fun, was a bit, sometimes a bit naughty, but anyway, we seemed to enjoy racing together. And we had some terrific races, and I think Brother Love again, we probably did go over top a few times.
Thank you.